So now let us discuss about the shunt feedback amplifier. How we can say this is transistance? So how the meaning of shunt feedback amplifier is the connection of the input as well as the output. The input also is a parallel connection, output also parallel connection. That is the meaning of it. So now next what we'll do, let us see what will be the input signal for this. So the input signal, for the this amplifier, it's nothing but voltage. The input signal is voltage. Whatever the output signal, the output signal is current. Okay, so that is my output is current actually. That is, I is equal to, then the input is voltage is as per the Ohm's law, I is equal to V divided by R. So V by R, so I can say that is nothing but the input is, sorry, I given a mistake. I gave some mistake here. Input is current, output is voltage, sorry. Input is current. Output is voltage. So now from this, I can write output is V. V is equal to the input is I. So I into R actually as Ohm's law. So this one we can call it's a trans resistance amplifier. So the input will be simple one resistor will be there. Like this is the input, the A circuit will have only one resistor, that is an amplifier circuit will have. So now let us see how the diagram will be there. For the ideal case of the diagram, let us take first, let us take the original diagram, how it will be there. See, this is the basic topology diagram we've seen. Like the input source, the RS will be there, basic transistors, then load. Now the equivalent diagram for the ideal structure will be. This is the equivalent structure. So thus, so we got this. So IS, right? So A into I, an independent source, output is voltage. The input is current. Input is current, output is voltage. So now we can see from the input side, the input resistance. From the output side, we can see the output resistance. See here. So here we written input resistance. There is the input resistance. There is input resistance, output resistance. So the feedback current here, what it will do normally, this will generate like a, it will generate a voltage, but it will sense the current. That is the meaning of that. So it will generate the voltage in the sense, if you want to measure the voltage across this, you need to connect a one voltmeter here. So now the feedback will be what? It will be beta into V naught because the output voltage is V naught. So now here, the circuit. It will have the input resistance, the RI, the trans resistance A, and the output resistance R naught in the A circuit. The A circuit has the internal resistance, that is input resistance, then trans resistance A. This is A is nothing but a trans resistance, then output resistance R naught. Then the beta circuit, this beta circuit is a voltage controlled current source. It is a voltage control current source. Which one? This beta circuit. So the beta circuit will be here. If this is a trans resistance, so this will be a transconductance. This will be a transconductance. Beta is nothing but a transconductance. So now from this, what we need to do, we have to calculate the closed loop gain. We have to calculate now. Okay, let's calculate the closed loop gain. So to find a closed loop gain, that is nothing but a AF. That is nothing but, we can say feedback gain, or we can say closed loop gain. Defined as where the AF is equal to, from this figure, what will be like? It's a ratio of the output voltage to the input current. That is, I can say V naught by IS. This is expression number one. So now from this above figure, what I will do, let us say in this input, we need to apply here. See, input, apply KCL. Okay, so apply KCL in the input. Right, KCL in the input. So when I apply the KCL in the input, what will get actually? So which node? So this node, you see this node. Okay, you take this node now. If you're considering this node now, I can say here the sum of outgoing current will be is equal to sum of incoming current. So from this, the sum of outgoing current is II, you know that. The incoming current is IS, as well as the one more current also I'm getting. See here, this current I'm getting. So this current is nothing but what's supposed to be beta into V naught. So from this, I can say II is equal to, II is equal to IS minus beta into V naught. I hope you better got it now. How we got? Apply KCL at this node. So II, that is outgoing node, the outgoing current is nothing but II. The incoming current is nothing but IS. The one more incoming current is nothing but IF. That is a beta V naught. This is the current, right? See? So now we can say II is equal to IS minus beta V naught. So from this, I can say, what is V naught? From the figure, what is V naught? This V naught. V naught is nothing but this. V naught is nothing but A into II. So V naught is equal to A into II. V naught is equal to A into II. So you take this equation number 3. Now what you do, substitute equation 2 in 3. Substitute equation 2 in 3. So when you substitute, what will you get? V naught is equal to, V naught is equal to A into I S minus beta into V naught. Now this will be your expression number 4. Now next, what you'll do? So just to do the simplification, into A beta V naught. So just to do the multiplication, I'll get us like this will be V naught minus not minus plus A into beta into V naught will be is equal to A into I. Yes, so take the common term as V naught, 1 plus A into beta will be equal to A into IS. So we know that what is AF? The AF is nothing but V naught by IS, output voltage by the input source. That is A divided by 1 plus A beta. So now we got it. So this will be your feedback gain for the trans resistance amplifier. Now what we'll do, let us find a input resistance, find a RIF, input resistance. So now how we can find out the input resistance now? So it is Very simple. What you need to do, we have to see from the input side. That is RIF is equal to, let me write, what is input resistance actually? RIF is equal to, this is a common formula, right? RIF is equal to, from the input side, VI divided by IS. See here, VIC, this will be yours, right? So this will be VI by IS. From seeing from the input port. So this box only, from the seeing, just from input port, that is what we can say. So now from input port, from this what I will do, let me write from the input port, what is II? What is II? II is equal to this, just you can say this current will be is equal to, same. Like what? KCL only you can say. II is equal to IS minus IF. Right? So now, where IS is equal to II plus IF. Next, we know that where beta is equal to not beta, IF is equal to, right? So let me write IF. What is IF? From the above figure, I can say beta into V naught. This we know. So now what you will do? Let us write RIF. So RIF is equal to II into RI. Why I'm writing IA that RI doesn't see example VA, where VI is equal to, we know that, where VI is equal to IA into RI. You see this figure, from the figure, the voltage across this, VI is equal to this voltage here. You see this, this IA into RI, that is voltage. Then divided by II plus beta into V naught. So now what we'll do? Do the simplification of this. So once you do the simplification, so we'll get RIF will be is equal to RI divided by 1 plus A beta we'll get. Just to do the simplification, we'll get the input resistance. So now this will be an input resistance. Now from this, we can note that the shunt connection at the input, that is the parallel connection, the input will result in a reduced input resistance because RI divided by means, as we know that the A and beta will be very large. If the A and beta is very, very large, greater than 1, then RI will get reduced. So that is a shunt, if you are connecting the shunt connection, parallel connection at the input. So from this, I can say the input resistance is a resistance, the seen by the source IS actually. And it include any source resistance. Okay, so next thing is what you have to do, we have to find out the third term. Find R naught F. That is output resistance. So what is the output resistance? To perform the output resistance, what I need to do? So something like we need to do something here. That's like, what is this in the sense? Let me say, what you have to do? First, we need to set V is equal to 0. Then what you have to do? You need to add a one voltage source in the output terminal. So doing that, we have to perform that. So let me do that. How it will be in the sense? So I will take the same diagram only here. I'm going to take the same diagram. Yes. So now the input earlier, it was current source was there. So now what you have to do? First, you have to set Vs is equal to 0. If I set Vs is equal to 0, what will happen? Current, automatic current also will become a 0. So it will become a short circuit. Next, what you have to do? Second is, you have to connect. If you are having a output is a voltage output, then you need to connect here one voltage source. If you are having the output in the output terminal, the current, then you need to add a test current. So connect voltage source. Voltage source. Right. Output terminal. So what you will do here, you need to output, you have to connect. So see, just you have to connect like this. So plus, minus, this is nothing but Vx current voltage. Then what is the current will go? Will get us Ix current. So this and all will be there, right? See, this connection and all will be there. So now from this, I can say, what is RF actually? The output resistance is the RF is equal to Vx by Ix. Okay, this is what you have to do. So now further what you will do, from the input port, just see from the, because seeing the output, right? So from the input port, as you know that, from the input port, II is equal to, as we know that already, II is equal to IS minus IF. As we know that II is equal to, what is this? This will be zero because VS is equal to zero minus IF, that will be minus IF. So what will get IF? II is equal to minus beta into V naught actually. This we know, right? This is the thing about IF. Where I can say V naught. Here I'm not using V naught. So instead of that, what I will do? I will use as the term which we used here, X. So IF is nothing but minus beta Vx actually. So beta Vx. So now what we'll do next from output port. Next. From output port. From output port, what is that now? Just apply like here. See, here also voltage source, here also voltage source. This is the current. So now what is the current here? Ix. Ix is equal to Vx minus A into II divided by R naught. So very simple. You can write. So Vx, sorry, not Vx, supposed to Ix is equal to. Ix is equal to Vx minus A into AI by R naught. You can take this equation number 3. So where is the equation number 1 and 2? Here, this is equation 1. This is equation number 2. Now substitute the respective terms. That is Vx minus A into IA already we got. That is minus beta into Vx divided by R naught. Then is equal to Vx plus A beta Vx divided by R naught. Then what will happen? This will be, I think, but your Ix actually, right? So still what you can do, take the common term as Vx, 1 plus A beta divided by R naught, that is Ix. Now from this, what I can say, what is R of Vx by Ix? So now you take it like this, Vx by Ix. So bring this Ix over there, R naught will go up over there. Divided by R naught upon 1 plus A beta. This is nothing but R naught F. So see here, here also you can see, check it now. See the output resistance, what we got, R naught by 1 plus A beta. See, input also we got RA by 1 plus A beta, because see, when we got a both are shunt connection, parallel connection, we got like this. So it is a one simple idea for you to how we'll get the output actually. Even here also, R naught also will get reduces because of the shunt connection of the output resistance will reduce. So let us see the next thing, that is shunt series feedback amplifier or current amplifier we can say. See, normally this shunt series feedback amplifier, current amplifier will not be used that much. Okay, so that is the reason. So we need to, no need to see so much of about this here. Just straight away, I'll write the answers, everything, but I'll draw the diagram. So first, let me write the input signal and output signal. What will be the input? What will be the output? Because from this itself, current volt amplifier means, so I can say the input as well as input and output signal, both are current. So if the input is current, even the output also is current, in the sense, what will be, that is nothing but a current amplifier. Sometimes it will be also called a current amplifier. The topology or the feedback which is used is shunt series feedback. Means the input will be shunt connection, the output will be series in connection. So now let us see how the diagram will be. Okay, so I forgot to put one thing here in the previously. So what will be the, after that, is the equivalent diagram of the previous structure, that is shunt. So equivalent structure, the sense after finding the input output. So this is very, very important. In examination, you need to draw this also. After doing this, you have to draw. Okay, so now let me draw the structure for current amplifier. So before that, current amplifier structure, as we know that, the original, how it will be, that is the current amplifier, the basic topology, it will be like this. Yes, see, input source is current, output also will be current only. Here the parallel connection, here we're using series connection. Now let us see the equivalent diagram of that. The sense, the ideal structure, the equivalent ideal structure. So here same, just the basic amplifier, so we'll be called A circuit. Now the A circuit has the input resistance and the A is nothing but a current gain actually here. Then output resistance, where the beta is nothing but also will be a feedback factor, will be a current gain only, beta also. It's a feedback factor. So now you can see here the input resistance as well as the output resistance, that is seen from the input side, input resistance seen from the output side, R naught F. Here we are having the parallel connection. You can see this. Here we are having the series connection in the output here. So means in this, what is happening over here in the sense, so here generating the current and it's sensing the voltage. Sorry, it's generating the current, it's sensing the current. That is the meaning of that. This is nothing but the output side is nothing but generation. So the input side only I can call as sensing. Always we have to do like this only. So the circuit will generate the current and it'll sense the input current. So now in this, let us, what you will do, let us first, we need to find out the feedback gain. So very simple, already we found so many things. So what is the AF? To find the AF here, so the AF is nothing but the feedback gain is nothing but the feedback gain AF is equal to what is output? Output is I naught. What is the input? Input is I, yes. So I don't want to discuss much about this. So very, very simple. So from the previous expression here also, we can write it is nothing but A divided by 1 plus A beta we'll get. Next, second, input resistance. To find the input resistance. The input resistance with the feedback. The resistance seen by a current source IS, it was given by straight away. I will write the value here. That is input resistance. It is nothing but the RIF is equal to, actually, what will be RIS is equal to VI by IS. VI by IS. That is after do, even you can do by yourself, you can try. RIF will get us because the input is parallel connection, right? Shunt connection, RI divided by 1 plus A beta. So very simple, straight away I can write. Next, third, find a output resistance, that is R0F. So now how we can find the output resistance? So output resistance will be easily found. That is the output we are having, which is current source. So you have to add the test current. R is equal to, it is like nothing but water. It is nothing but V by IX. V by IX, the current. IX or I1, I can say. Test current you have to add. So we'll get as R naught of, here is output is series connection or shunt connection. The output is series connection. So very simple. R naught of is equal to R naught into 1 plus A beta. So it is very, very easy for you to write this input resistance, output resistance, knowing the series or parallel network. So here we can say, note that there will be increase in the output resistance here is due to the current series sampling, because the current series sampling this one. So this I can say current series sampling. So from this, I can say current mixing and current sampling, I can say this actually.